All right, head coach Ray Bigori, senior wide receiver Justin Watson, junior safety Sam Filippi. Coach, opening statement.
Obviously, disappointing that our kids worked hard, prepared hard, and the fourth quarter has not been nice to us. But from the get-go, I thought we had opportunities to make some plays and move it, and we had started with the first punt we had, and we short hit it and out of bounds and create field position for them and whatnot. Some of the turnovers, some open plays, and collectively the kids played hard. I love their effort. I love how they battled right to the very last play. So their hearts are in it. Not capitalizing on the opportunity we have. Drive right before the first half, obviously they put points on, and the last drive of the game, we got to get them out of those drives. But again, probably the biggest word is inconsistent, that we're just not hitting on those cylinders. And as long as, again, you look at these situations that happen, I think we got to remember how we got here, and that is through hard work and everybody just taking a look at each other, what we do, what we don't do, right or wrong, and try to continually build upon, the sentiments, positives, and try to move forward to, again, the kids, the efforts there, and just applaud the kids for doing that.
Questions?
Ray, the sequence at the end of the first half when it looked like you might have had a touchdown pass that didn't happen and then they had one, how significant was that?
Yeah, anytime you share points and you not get a lot, that's huge. I thought as they were going down the back end, the official threw the flag. I guess I saw a little different than perhaps he did and the tripod. And again, you've got to put people out in those situations, go ahead with the lead in those things. But it's capitalizing. It's a missed pass. And again, special teams, again, we have the high snap. He snares it. That guy that comes down with it. But we short hit the punt. You don't change field position. It's really, really hard to scratch and claw for every yard. So it gets magnified in games like this when you're playing good football teams. And they hit, they ran them up. But again, I think our guys stood there and went toe-to-toe, for four quarters, and I'm proud of how they responded to that.
Can you talk about using the two quarterbacks today?
Sure. We thought about it, and we have been early in the year. We had gone with that. We thought that, Nick is different than Will. Nick is a little bit more spark with his feet as things began to break down. They were getting heavy rush on us during the course of the game. Really feel that's probably a strong point in Nick's, skill set, and that's why he was there. And then, when it comes on the throw, and again, you can go through a couple balls there that were, dropped, and, you try to capitalize it. So it's just, something we went, as far as the week went on, we needed to do that to give us a spark, change up the pace, and really coming into the game, I think they had 22 sacks in 5 games, so we knew they were going to bring the people up front, so having an escapability, which you saw during the course of the game. That weapon of with a quarterback's feet are very, very important. And that's, becomes a difference between extending drives or not. You can have them covered like a blanket, but if you can't hit that quarterback when he's scrambling, it becomes huge, which down the end of the game, I think that get us on the same, very, very similar to that kind of touchdown.
Fourth quarter, 3 weeks in a row. Does that start with the mental at a certain point?
It's mental, it's finishing. I'm not sure mental in terms of our kids are thinking that way. It's just a matter of finishing it. I think when you look at the game, we said this as a staff, as a team, I think you guys will attest to it. It comes down to everybody, sharpening themselves up on 2 or 3 things apiece. Okay, and if you're able to maximize that, 11 guys on offense, 11 guys on defense, and if you just sharpen those pieces, there's a difference between that fourth quarter win and that fourth quarter loss. And I think that's where we're really victims of that the last couple of weeks. Again, play here, play there, you're your adage, but there's probably a little bit more than just that one play. The one play leads back into a fourth, first quarter mishap, you should have, could have type of a thing. And if you hit that long field goal, if you hit this, you hit that, it's something that you just sit there and you extend drives. Again, give them long field, great punts and field position and all those little things. So I think we have to self-examine everything that we do and just to try to drive it home. I'm going to keep on reiterating, it's a kid's heart. A kid's heart. We're a football team out there today. I'm going to give be also incredible on the other side. We have a good football team. And they'll sit there and they'll punch in good in those battles and just not win us up, win that last bell.
Can you talk about some of the play calling you guys had in the fourth quarter after back-to-back turnovers you guys committed?
In reference to something in particular, or
when you guys were trying to go down for the lead at the end?
Sure. I'm not sure if you're talking about something specifically. I think we're trying to run opportunities in there. Their corner was out. We're trying to get different scenarios with Justin and that from the play. Obviously, the game of football, every play is designed for a touchdown. Okay, and somewhere, somehow, they get the extra piece where they were not blocking in the right way. They make a good play. We don't make a good play. And, I think it's not about the plays themselves. I think it comes down to the execution of what you're trying to get done. I think that builds upon it. One has to do right with the other. So, again, obviously, you always want to call a play into the right scenario. But, sometimes they do some things that you're not expecting and whatnot. And,
Justin, how tough is it was today and the last couple of weeks to have leads and then break in to lose games like this?
Yeah, just losing hurts, whether you had a lead or didn't. It's never easy. I thought the last couple of weeks we had a couple of great weeks of practice, so we're not going to change that. We're just going to keep working. That's kind of the mantra since I've been here, is keep going back to work, win or lose, and that's what we're going to keep doing.
You're going to, for the first time in 3 years, not going to win the Ivy League, pretty much that. It's disappointing, the two-time fan here.
Yeah, it's tough. We're just going to keep taking one week at a time. We don't talk about that period a whole lot. We talk about going 1-0, and like I said, we lose a period. I don't like going off the field and hugging my family after a loss, and I know there's a locker room full of guys that feel the same way, so we're just going to keep going out, keep trying to be 1-0, and represent this program the best we can.
You seemed pretty animated on the sidelines in the fourth quarter.
I was just trying to get you guys going. Just reminding them all the work we put into this and how much this means to each one of us. And right after that, guys, we just scored a touchdown and defense is playing well. I didn't think it was a good thing or a hard thing at the end. Everyone was bought in and wanted to be out there and wanted to score that touchdown on that last drive.
Coach, can you talk about the thinking that went into the decision to punt when you guys had the ball with about 4 minutes remaining?
Sure. Well, again, if it wasn't going to be fourth down and 10, we got a couple of yards on it, we had gone into it saying, what's the thing about going for it on fourth, if it was a tight, tight short field, there's not many good fourth and 10 plays to dial up there. Okay, so we thought we'd change field position, which we did with a really good kick, and we had stopped them during the course of the drives. If we can get a three and out, we get the ball back. You start playing clock. You play clock management there. If that was fourth and three, my decision would be to hold it. Fourth and five, a little bit different. Again, the odds exponentially grow, less and less as you get those fourth down situations in the longer.
Did you change your mind earlier when you kicked the field goal, or did you just called the timeout after you like it?
Yeah. Well, we were looking at that situation, and from a standpoint, Coach Ray went out there. And he didn't like the look that was being presented, what they were going to do, and our set and our formation. And we decided to run him out. He had the leg was there, he just hit wide right. I guess he would have come clear by a pretty good leg swing there. And Jack has been a positive sign on his kickoffs and his field goals of late. Our decision to hit the field goal later on was, which was good, but we felt that was going to give us, we needed to get it at some point in time.
His development, Zach, has it been more than you could have expected?
I think like everything else, with every player, it's what you hope would be developed, with it. For a young player who, played, limited in the past, especially in that role, and his kickoff leg has been that way last year. He's had a great, powerful leg, but now his focus is concentration. And, I go back to these guys who probably still well in high school and grad school who lost three overtime games in a row. Somewhere around 2005, I think it was 2006, and that was really tough. And it was for various reasons, and various reasons. So I think it would echo what Justin said, losing is hard no matter what you do. It's all about the fight and his commitment to that fight and that effort.
Say anything about the defense forcing the turnovers and how important that was for the day today?
Yeah,
I mean, that's what we stress every day in practice, turnovers and takeaways. We know that's our job, and we know we need to get that done. And I don't think it's something that or it's something that we do make it happen because everybody's running to the ball and everybody's playing physical. And it's definitely something that we stress a lot more this week and during the game. We always set a quota for our defense for how many turnovers and takeaways we want. So that's kind of something we push for every game. And we definitely thought it was important, or especially in the fourth quarter, when you do those stops and turnovers.
How tough was the Yale money game today? Do you think maybe that might prove to be the difference?
Sure. I think when you games are close by margin, okay, they can keep you balanced. Right, I think we've enjoyed in years past when you get up on people and get a lot of points. I think what happens is it takes people out of the game. Okay, when the score is relatively close with your head, now first down and 10, second and mediums, you got to defend everything, and that's really, really hard. I think the part of the game is you got to try to win first down, get them to predictable situations, and if you don't do that through that run game, it's difficult. And obviously, score and tie the ebb and flow of the game are also so key into that stuff. Good running game. I thought our kids fits them real well. I think we had them stopped, and I think 33 did a really good job of bouncing through. They went through some tackles in there. I knew that was going to be that case, but hopefully that making it more passing situation with the lead at the end, but we didn't have that.
Take one more question if anyone has one.
Will you be using two quarterbacks the rest of the season?
We're going to evaluate everything we do. The staff will come back in tomorrow. We'll look at what we're doing, how we're doing it. I think what we do is evaluate, our progression to the game. And that will be definitely hard. That which gives us the best opportunity to go out there and beat Brown next weekend, get our kids back to that winning side, the left-hand side of the ledger.
All right, thank you, Coach. Thank you, gentlemen. John, I'll take you out to...